now I feel a pang of pain and distress that such an illustrious institution, whose owner is the only Padma Shri winner in India, that it should fold up.
This was my favorite place to bring my nephews to whenever they came to Bombay, and then I would buy books for them. And the last time I bought books here was for my nephew's children. So it's like three generations that have enjoyed Strand Book Store, and we're going to really miss it.
So we feel very sorry that it's closing down, because it was an institution, as far as I'm concerned, since 74.
I guess it's a combination of the Amazon effect and the big chains. It's a passing of history.
So my name is Vidya Virkar, and actually I'm the daughter of Padma Shri T and Shanbhag. It was my father who founded Strand Book Stall. And there's a very cute little story that actually has been talked about by the media a lot, because it is such an inspirational one. He was a poor student who had come in from Karnataka, and he was studying in Xavier's College. And every month he was such a bookworm that he used to save up a few, annas or whatever, to buy a penguin a month. That was all he could afford. So one day when he went to a very large bookstore to purchase a penguin, the officious salesperson said, "Young man, you can't open the book. You have to just look at it and decide if you want to buy it. You're not allowed to browse in this shop." So my father was so humiliated. He said, "If you can't do that, please leave. So if you can't buy it, just leave." So he was so humiliated that he went off and sat at an Irani restaurant over a cup of tea. And that is what actually led to his very deep contemplation about the nature of a book, about the nature of reading, and what it meant to have a bookshop. And what came out was, he decided that somehow, in spite of not having any money, he would start his own little bookshop, and he would give as big price offs and discounts so that people could afford reading and to read more. And also, he said he would never turn away somebody for browsing. So this led him, again through great thought, he couldn't afford a space. So he went to the only theater in Mumbai. This is 1948 we're talking about. India had just become newly independent. It was just a year of independence that we have had by then. So he went to the Strand Cinema and he asked the manager whether he could put up two shelves in the corner of the lounge where people come out for during the intermission, so that they might buy a book. And it happened to be a very nice Parsi gentleman called K.K. Modi, who was so impressed. He said, "Young man, I shall put up the two shelves for you." So this is what happened, and Dad started bringing in selected books, curated books, as we say today, from abroad, from UK in those days, a few of them, but they were so well chosen, and he knew so much about it, that when the very highly educated gentry of Mumbai, who came for an English film, came there during intermission, they were very impressed, because he used to talk about the book. He started giving a discount of 20% from the very first day, though he could ill afford it. But they started buying a book from him every time they came to the cinema. That was how Strand Book Stall began. 8 years passed. His popularity had already really gone, I think, grown and grown. And the likes of the Birlas and the Tatas and the Godridges and such very, top flight families were coming for English films. And also, people from central South Mumbai. Mumbai was mainly South Mumbai. So he became quite well known. And subsequently, he was given the space for a small rental by someone who recommended his name. And he started Strand here in this venue at Fort and kept the name Stall, Strand Book Stall. One thing I will say is that Strand, over the years, the very fact that it opened in 1948, looking back, this is what I felt, is that my father was actually given that purpose in life whereby he was, you know, going to supply international literature and knowledge, bring it into India, into post-independence India, for India's post-independence intellectuals. So this is exactly how it looks like, doesn't it? This is the first proper Indian English bookstore getting imported material curated the very year after independence. And as a result, all our leaders were making a beeline for this place. There were many that, you know, names that we don't know today or we have forgotten, because we are not always in touch with history. But the preeminent ones were Jawaharlal Nehru, you know, and I think his sister, I think Sarojini Naidu may have also been, you know, she, I think, one, or it's Krishna Hathi Singh, I think one of them lived in Bombay. And she told Jawaharlal Nehru that, you know, when you come to Mumbai, you must visit Strand. So one thing led to another, a phone call was made, and my father was contacted, and he suggested to Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru to come after hours. We locked the door and he was alone, no crowds outside, no one knew he was here, and he could browse and take books that he wanted. And subsequently dad actually went to Delhi a couple of times and took some very wonderful titles for him, which led the Prime Minister to ask him, young man, I can afford books at the original price. Why is it you're giving me a discount of 20%? So my father said, Your Excellency, it is my duty to serve our leaders. Yeah. So that was the spirit. This is the spirit with which he approached it. And it is exactly that which happened. Manmohan Singh was RBI governor. Little did we know that he'd one day be leading the country, in, you know, and he used to come here very, very regularly, maybe every second or third day. This was his lunchtime haunt. Because he is a very scholarly man. APJ Abdul Kalam, nobody imagined that a very humble scientist from TIFR, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, would one day head the country as president of India. So Sir Vikram Sarabhai, who was the head of the Bombay Atomic Research, BARC, at that time, was a regular. He used to pick up his books here. Yes. So he one day brought Kalam along and he said, Abdul, meet Mr. Shanbhag. This is the bookseller whose recommendations you ignore at your own peril. This story was recounted to us when my father got a Padma Shri and we had gone to Rashtrapati Bhavan. After the medals and all are given, there is a tea ceremony. I mean, there's a tea, high tea, when you can interact with the ministers and with the president. And my father approached the president, Abdul Kalam, as it happened, at that time. And he's the one who gave that the medal, you know, the Padma Shri. So he said, Your Excellency, you may not remember me, but I am Mr. Shanbhag. So he said, how can I forget you? And he gave that story with, you know, wagging his finger. So dad had been running it for years, and I was in England studying, and I decided that studying and then subsequently working, but I coaxed my husband that we should come back to India, because I said, we have a legacy store, an iconic store, and I don't want that legacy to be allowed to die. So I came back and I joined dad to become a partner 25 years ago. Given that I'd come back to run the legacy store so it should not perish, taking a decision to actually close this very legacy store which I had come to take on and continue even after dad was no more, it was a tough fall, but the point is, it was also a slow progression, shall we say, because I've spent years observing the scenario and making very sure that, you know, there might be some things that I have not tried. I've tried numerous marketing techniques, We've had newsletters, we've had online, we've had an online presence which did fairly okay till the big guys came in. Okay, we had a very nice online presence. So the big guys came in and just flooded the market with their high discounts. So that's when the real downfall began, you know. And subsequently now, there are many other distractions that people have. Apart from online, there are many other things that are happening. So, you know, coming to the reason why I had to shut the shop, it is not competition with another bookshop or, you know, that kind of a thing. Or, even not necessarily with an online bookshop. It is actually competing for mind space with so many other forms of entertainment and information that are available today, as you know. WhatsApp gives you so many bits of information. Google, you just Google up something, you know something on health, something on the world, you can travel, you don't need a travelogue, you can just print out something on Peru and go there. You want to, get some information about a nice recipe, you just look it up, you don't buy cookery books anymore. So little by little, different categories started getting eaten into. So did it result in a fall in footfall? Definitely. This too was gradual because people too hadn't adapted to the online, people hadn't adapted to the new environment, the culture scape as I call it. But the thing is, eventually they would. Because the other thing that is happening in all our cities is high traffic density and bad roads. So coming all the way to Strand for a couple of books becomes unfeasible. So there are a mixture of reasons which we cannot fight. If it is only another bookstall, we might take it on and do it with all our flourish, right? And do something that's unique and different. But it's not that. It's not this. Neither is it that. It is everything.